Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to be teaching you guys how we can create radio buttons in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay everybody, let's create some radio buttons. Now these are similar to checkboxes, but you can only select one from any single grouping. So let's pretend that I'm buying you lunch, and you can only select one item from a menu. You can select either a slice of pizza, a hamburger, or a hot dog. So let's begin by creating a list. I will call this list food. Food equals pizza, hamburger, hot dog. And let's create a window. Window equals TK, followed by window.mainloop. So to create a radio button, we'll need a name, so I'll call this radio button. Radio button equals radio button. And we're going to be adding this to our window. And we're going to put this within a for loop, so we're going to iterate through all of the items within our list. So let's create a for loop. So we'll say for index in range length of food. So this is going to iterate once through all of the elements within our list. So when we run this, it's going to create three radio buttons for us because we're instantiating one radio button for each item in the list. Now what I'm going to do is set the text equal to our list of food at a certain index. So when we first run this for loop, it's going to be 0 for the index, then 1, and then 2, and then so on and so forth for each item within our list. And then we just need to pack this. So radio button dot pack. And then let's take a look at this. All right, so here are all of the radio buttons that we have. Currently they're all selected though, so we'll need to link these within a single grouping. The next thing we'll add is a variable. And we'll set this equal to x, and we'll need to declare this after we create an instance of our window. So x equals int var. So this will hold an integer object. So these are all within the same grouping. However, if we try to run this again and select one of these options, they all become selected. So we're going to need to give each of these individual radio buttons their own value, because right now they're all sharing the same value. So we can add value equals whatever the index is currently. So the first item within our list of food is going to have an index value of 0, then 1, then 2. So let's try that again. And you can see by default it's 0, so pizza is already selected. Then we can select either hamburger or hot dog, but we can only select one. So that's kind of what we want then. So do you guys usually know how I call the config function after each change that I make for an object? Well, that's because I like to add comments just for teaching purposes for what each change does. However, it might be easier for you instead of calling the config function a bunch of times just to list all of the changes within the parentheses when you create an instance of the object that you're working with. However, just for teaching purposes, I'm going to put this all within separate lines. That allows me to add some comments. So I think I'm going to start doing that from now on. So what this does is that this adds text to radio buttons. And this groups radio buttons together if they share the same variable. So if you wanted a completely different grouping of radio buttons, you can give them a different variable like y. And what this line does is that this assigns each radio button a different value. All right, so let's make some cosmetic changes to our radio buttons. So right now, they are centered. Let's anchor these to the west. So we'll place this within the pack function. So anchor equals W. Alternatively, you can just say capital W without the quotes. This would also work too. So now they're all lined up. Let's add some padding. So I'm going to add pad X, and I'll set this to 25. And this adds padding on X axis. Let's also change the font. So we'll say font equals, maybe I'll pick impact for a font style, and set the font size to 50. And now we can actually read these because the font is large enough. Now let's add some images. So let's create some photo images. You'll want to be sure to create these after you create your instance of your window. So let's create a pizza image first. Pizza image equals photo image file equals the file path or the file name. And my file is pizza.png, and it kind of looks like this. It's just the pizza emoji. So pizza.png. And then I'll do the same thing for hamburger and hot dog. So this will be hamburger image, file equals hamburger.png, and then hot dog image. And this is what the other emojis look like. And then let's create a list of the photo images that we have. I'll call this food images equals then the names of these images. Pizza image, hamburger image, and hot dog image. So then we can set the image for each radio button. Image equals the name of the list, food images, followed by the index that we're currently on within our for loop. So this adds image to radio button. And let's test this. Cool. Here's our images. Now, if you want some images as well as text, you'll have to use compound. So let's add that next. So I'm just going to add a comma followed by compound equals, let's say left. So this will add the image to the left of the text. Adds image and text. I'll just say left side. So this will display both an image and text. So with these radio buttons, you can eliminate these circle indicators, and there's actually a way to do that. So what we'll add, if you want to get rid of those, is indicator on equals zero. So this will, I should say, eliminate circle indicators. So it's going to change these to these push buttons. However, they are going to be of uneven size. You can set the width if you want to. So we'll do that. So we'll say width equals, what about 75? I'm not sure if that's a good size or not. Okay, that's way too small. Let's try 375. So yeah, you can have some push buttons if you want to, if you don't like the circle indicators. So this sets width of radio buttons. Now let's actually set a function to be called when we click one of these buttons. So let's call this function maybe order, like we're ordering one of these items. So def, we'll call this order, like we're ordering something. And what we'll do is just a few if statements because I'm feeling lazy. So we'll just say if x, that's the value that's going to be stored because each of these radio buttons is grouped together by the variable x. If x dot get is equal to zero, that's our first index for pizza. What we'll display is print You ordered pizza. Then we'll just add else if x.get is equal to 1, we will print you ordered a hamburger. And then else if 2, you ordered a hot dog. Else, print, huh? So there's probably a more efficient way to write this. However, I was just feeling lazy, and this is probably the best way to keep this simple and easy to understand. So let's try this now. Oh, however, we need to set the command for our radio buttons. So command equals then the function name, which is order. And make sure you do not add the parentheses. So don't do this, do that. And this will set command of radio button to function. All right, let's test this. So if we click on pizza, it says you ordered pizza, you ordered a hamburger, and you ordered a hot dog. Okay, everybody, so that's the basics of radio buttons. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of radio buttons in Python. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.